Hi, this is Anne with SVG Cut File, and today I'm going to help you decide which file is right for you, the one that ends in SVG, DXF, or PNG. All right, let's get started. Okay, so most online design sellers include a few file types for cutting machines, and a very popular combination is SVG, DXF, and PNG files. And the reason these are included really is because our customers have requested those types of files. So I want to go over what those files mean for you. Let's start with the Cricut machine. If you're using your Cricut for cutting, the best file for you is the SVG file. SVG stands for Scalable Vector Graphic. I'm going to go ahead and upload one now. So I'll come over here to upload. I'll choose upload image and I'll browse. And then I've got one right here that ends in SVG. This is the best type of file for Cricut. So we'll click open. And you'll see it has a transparent background. Most of the time they will, but they don't have to have a transparent background. Then we'll hit save and I'll click the file and then insert images. And it might take a couple seconds, but the file will come up on your screen. And so this is what an SVG file looks like in Cricut Design Space. SVG stands for Scalable Vector Graphic. And basically, that means you can make the file as big as you want and it'll never get pixelated or blurry. SVG files are great to use with cutting machines because they have layers. If you look over here to the right side of your screen, you'll see all of these layers that are included with this. And there's one layer for each piece of it, unless they've been welded together. So as you can see, this green area, all the green pieces have been welded, and then these white pieces have been welded also. So they're just one layer. The nice thing about having these layers is that Cricut doesn't have to guess where to cut your file. It's already been told by the designer where the cuts are. That information is stored in the SVG file. And we can select the design, we can ungroup it right here under layers, and that will just allow us to move the pieces around separately if we want to. Because the file is set up this way, we can cut our different colors and layers without having to trace anything. Now, even if you're wanting to do a print and cut, which most people use PNG files for those, but you can use an SVG file for print and cut. All you would have to do is select everything and then come over here to flatten. And when you do that, it creates one layer out of everything. Obviously, I did not line this up very well, but you can see up here that it says cut and print. We have a little error here, and when I click that, it says that our image is too large. We have to have it 6.75 inches by 9.25 inches or less to use as a print and cut image. So we would just reduce it, and then our error would go away. So now it's ready for print and cut. So you can use SVG files for print and cut too. So you could basically print this on a transfer sheet, and then Cricut will go in and cut around all of the edges so that you don't have to basically do it with scissors. The second type of file is a DXF file. A DXF is a lot like an SVG, but some cutting machines don't take SVG, and they do take the DXF. So Silhouette is one of the types of cutting machines that don't allow DXF with their free software. But the DXF is also a vector file, and it works very similarly as an SVG. So let's open one now. I'll go to Silhouette Studio. I'll choose Open right up here. And then I'll navigate to this DXF file and say OK. It'll take a second to load it up, and then it'll be in here. Now, even if the designer has welded and grouped things, inside Silhouette Studio Basic, everything is ungrouped, unwelded, and uncolored, but it will still cut the same. Also, the cut lines are available, and you can resize it with no problem because it's a vector file. You won't have blurriness or pixelation. Silhouette Basic is pretty basic, honestly. If you use Silhouette machines a lot, I recommend just paying for the upgraded software, which is less confusing, especially if you have multiple colors. The third type of file is the PNG file, and there are two main ways that this file type is different from an SVG. The first is that a PNG can get really pixelated or blurry if it isn't saved at a high enough resolution, and also if you increase the size of the image too much. So that is one way that it's different. It is not a vector graphic, so it's not really scalable, meaning you can make it smaller, but you just can't make it bigger, otherwise it'll get blurry. The other difference is that a PNG file is flat, so that means you cannot ungroup it or move the layers to cut it with a Silhouette or Cricut machine. Let's go ahead and open this file in Cricut Design Space. I'm going to delete this one, and then I'll upload the PNG file. We'll come up here to Upload Image, we'll browse, and we'll come to this PNG file and open. Now we get a different screen. And the reason we're getting this screen is because Cricut doesn't know where the lines are. So it's going to try to guess where to make the cut lines in this image. Usually when you're bringing a PNG file in, you'll want to go to Complex here. So we'll click that and then we'll continue. This is really a huge file, so I'm going to zoom out a little bit. If they're really big files, that's a good thing because it means that it's probably not going to be blurry if you resize it. Now at this point, we can preview what this is going to look like. Right now we've got some strange lines in here where Cricut decided there was a line, but it didn't do a very good job. So this is the type of thing you're going to run into when using a PNG file. Now you can separate all the colors out so you don't have a big blob like this, and I actually have another video showing how to do that, and it'll be on your screen above. But in the end, you can probably get it pretty close to what you saw in the SVG file earlier. Just remember that the main difference is with the PNG file, Cricut doesn't know where to cut and is going to guess, and your results might not be great. With the SVG file, it will see where to cut because those lines are already saved in the file itself. Long story short, SVG file is always better for cutting. Now the PNG file is also usually going to have a transparent background, and that makes them perfect for mock-up images. Basically, if you wanted to showcase your image on a blank t-shirt, like this one, you can just use the PNG file, put it on top of that, and it looks like you've printed it. So I'll show you what I mean. I'm going to drag this into Adobe Photoshop, and then I'll drag the PNG file into the same document. You can see it doesn't have a background, and that's perfect because we want to have the white of the t-shirt show through. So we can just kind of rotate it, put it on here like this, and now we could save this file and use it as a marketing image. So PNGs are perfect if you want to use them for mockups. So I hope this video has helped to clear up which file you should use. Generally speaking, the SVG is going to be your best bet. If your software won't take SVG, you're going to want to use the DXF file. And if you don't have anything except a PNG file, by all means, use the PNG file. All right, if you like this video, just click on the like button, and I'll see you next week with another SVG cut file tutorial. Thank you!